Hello. We are now down to the part two of our topic about tolerances and allowances. Okay, now so we're going to tackle this problem. A shaft with a nominal diameter of 8 inches is to fit in a hole. Specify the allowance and tolerances of the shaft and hole in a sketch for A, if it is a closed sliding fit, B, a precision running fit, a medium running fit, and a loose running fit. Okay, so in this problem, there are four requirements, and it requires to determine the allowances and tolerances for different fits. Specifically, kaning close sliding fit, precision running fit, medium running fit, and the loose running fit. Okay, now so this means each of these fit have different specified tolerances, and makita nato ni siya sa table 3.1. Okay, now so let's start with the first requirement, allowances and tolerances if it is a closed sliding fit. So ang atong kuan ni, ang gamito na to nga basis sa atong pag-determine sa allowances and tolerances is we're going to follow the basic hole system or a hole-based system. So in this system is ang shaft mo ay mag-adjust sa mag-adjust or mo to siya ang applyan sa allowance. Okay, so using basic hole system, so sa basic hole system is let's look up table 3.1. So sa table 3.1, pangitaon na to sa kung asa nga section ang kuan katong given nga dimension na to, and we are given that the dimension is or the nominal diameter of the shaft is 8 inches. So muna ang nominal diameter. So sa nominal diameter, the hole is ang given nga tolerance for the hole is that is plus 0.8 and minus 0. So sa kaning both nga kaning quantities or figures ani is multiply pa nato ni siya og 10 raised to the power of negative 3. While sa shaft, ang tolerance para sa shaft is negative 0.6 for the upper limit, no? Then minus 1.2, and these units are in inches. Okay, so wala gi state sa problem nga pilang allowance, but in order nga makuanta maka apply tog allowance sa kaning problem is we'll use katong the system of the basic hole system. So sa basic hole system, so it means nga ang hole is fixed ang diameter sa hole. So it is the diameter of the shaft nga mo yatong i-adjust. So gikan diri is that we'll read the tolerance nga give given for a shaft of 8 inches diameter. Diba na siya upper limit of negative 0.6 raised times 10 to the power of negative 3. Okay, so kani siya is muna siya ang lower limit. So muna siya ang pinaka kuan. Muna siya ang pinaka the smaller of the two nga kuan nga tolerances. That's kani ang atong i-apply nga allowance, the closest one. Okay? So gikan diri is that we can have, we will have the allowance of equal to negative 0.6 10 raised to the power of negative 3, or simply since allowance is we can simply declare it as 0.006. So this is by using the using the lower tolerance for the shaft. So then atong i-express na to ang kuan, ang tolerance sa hole og sa kuan, sa hole og sa shaft. Hole is this is the standard notation, no? Standard notation in expressing the tolerance. So diameter diri is hole diameter is 8.0 ang upper tolerance is that this is unilateral tolerance since we are only allowed by the basic hole system nga kanisya is fixed, but we can increase the size of the hole. Thus, using the upper limit of the given tolerance is 0.008. Then sa ubos is negative 0 inches. While sa shaft, ang i-butang na nato nga diameter na to sa shaft is muna siya ang adjusted sa allowance. So 8.0 minus 0.006 is 7.994. So then, since this is already adjusted sa allowance, then upper limit niya is plus 0.0 minus pila man tong sa lower limit sa kuan na to. Lower limit niya sa shaft sa given tolerance is negative point. Negative, this is negative 0.0012. So ato na siyang i-minus gi sa iyang upper limit since we have already subtracted it sa iyang nominal diameter. So thus this is negative 0.0006 inches. Right, so this is our first thing. This is the answer sa itong first thing, requirement. Okay, so let's now go with the second requirement. Which is to determine the allowances and tolerances if it uses precision running feet. Okay, so sa precision running feet, it is classified as RC3. Okay, now so simply just like what we did with the first requirement, katong slow sliding feet, which was RC1. Ang kuan nato, mag-look up lang ta sa table gikan sa kung asa natunong tong kung asa natunong range ang 8.0 na nominal diameter. Then pagitaon nato ang tolerance para sa table under sa table RC3. Okay, so sa table the same with sa table 3.1 table 3.1 for RC3 at 8 inches nominal diameter. Okay, no, so this is under niya, so sa carriage nominal diameter, the tolerances for the hole is plus 1.2 manig given, no? Then minus 0 sa shaft, negative 3.2 our allowance, therefore, is kani. May natong allowance. Okay. Allowance is then 0.002 inches. Okay, so expressing the standard notation for the tolerances of the hole and the shaft, plus 0.0012 minus 0 inches, then the shaft, so, ito yung minus ang 8 sa kuno sa allowance, which is 7.998 plus 0 10 negative 0.0012 inches. Right. Next, let's go to top of the icon. So this is it. Okay. How about if the fit is a medium running fit? Okay, now the medium running fit is kuan ni siya, duha ni siya ka kuan the identifying kuan classification sa RC. So it's kuan RC5 and RC6. Okay, so mupili tag either og RC5 and RC6. Okay, so there is no mention nga unsa ang specific nga kanya, specific nga application niya. Kay ang RC6 is mas taas siya tolerance comparing sa RC5. Thus, if we are going to decide kung asa ang piliyon na to in between sa duha, is that kung asa siya mas appropriate sa iyang application. So our initial assumption aniniya is ang gamito na to is ang RC5. Okay, no? At, unless otherwise kung gi-kuan gi-specify niya kung asa gyud ang iyang application nga it is imperative nga mo gamit ta og mas higher tolerance or kung higher tolerance or mas luag ang iyang fit, then we may use RC6. But in this example, gamitan na to ang RC5. So for RC5, table 3.1. For RC5 at 8 inches nominal diameter. Okay, 8.0 for the hole, no? The hole is 1.8. For the shaft, this is -4.0. Okay, so nominal dia is -4.0, -5.8. Okay, so therefore our allowance allows to is you will use the lower tolerance. Allowance is therefore 0.004. Okay, so the same with the katong first two mga requirements, thus the tolerance expression is that for the hole is that 8.0 plus 0.0018 inches. So shaft, yes, minus lang na to, ang 8 sa allowance is 7.996 plus 0, -0.0018. So, kung yung 0.0018 is muna siya ang i-subtract na to ang katong lower na tolerance 5.8 sa upper na tolerance niya nga 4. So this is R and multiplied it by 10 raised to the power of -3. So this is our final answer para sa kanilang requirement. Okay. Now for the last requirement is if the fit is loose running. Okay, so sa loose running fit, duha ni siyang RC ani. This is RC8 and RC9. Okay, so the same case with the medium running fit nga unless nga na-specify niya nga unsa nga application nga that will prompt us to select a loser or kanang mas luag nga fit is we may use RC9. But for this example is that RC8 ang atong gamiton. Table 3.1 RC8. Okay, so for the hole is this is plus 7. -0 for the shaft. This is -10. -14.5 ang lower tolerance niya. Okay, so simply ang atong allowance is 0.01 inches. Therefore, tolerance is 8.0 plus 0.007 minus 0. Then for this shaft is 8 minus 0.01, this is 7.99. then difference of the lower and upper tolerances for the shaft is 0.0045. okay, kalintino di kalintan ang inches. Alright, so that is muni ang tanang requirements nato for this problem. Okay, now let's go to the relationship between tolerances and the surface finish. Okay, so the surface finish is it depends kung sa ang final nga kuan, final treatment sa kuan, so sa ka surface, so sa ka metal, so sa ka steel. So it could be pwede na siya gamitan og honing, gamitan na siya og or other nga mga methods of of getting its final surface finish, and it depends sa unsang type of application. So kana siya if kung for example log honing nga which gigamitan og finer nga technique niya, is therefore mas smooth siya, matawag nog smooth contrast sa katong coarser or coarser nga type of honing or other kuan. It could be reaming or other methods. So kung smoother versus the coarser nga type of surface finish is kuan siya, dito magadepende kung pila ang o kung sa ang tolerance nga atong gamiton. Because for example, if we want to insert a shaft in a gear hub, so we want a tighter fit between sa two, because we want the shaft and the gear hub to work as one or to move as one. So the goal of inserting the shaft sa gear hub is more friction. So more friction, okay, we don't allow ang na relative motion sa duha. So naano siya specific nga surface finish para sa katong shaft. So therefore, mag-play siya og factor ang kan surface finish kung sa ang tolerance nato nga gamiton. So there is a close relationship between the smoothness and how fine the tolerance can be made. So in the table 3.4 na sa kuan yapon sa reference textbook, is that there are a range of nominal diameter, and there are gitawag mga grades, no? These grades are the surface finish of a material. So kaning 4, 5 up to 13 is it refers to different nga mga surface finishes. So lapping and honing, cylindrical grinding are different nga surface finish techniques, and they have different coarseness and smoothness nga results sa surface sa material, and therefore they have different mga tolerance nga i-assign nga na niya. Okay, so for example, for grades 4 to 5 is this refers to surface finish that through lapping and honing. 5, 6, 7 is if it involves either or combination of cylindrical grinding, surface grinding, diamond grinding, boring, and broaching. Okay, now so if you give it a problem nga mo ni siya ang surface finish sa kaning material, you just have to select kung asa ni nila. For example, if it is a kuan, it is a combination of kani cylindrical grinding and lapping and honing, then you can select grade 5. Okay. So 6 to 10 is if it includes reaming. Okay, now so kining 6 to 10 is inclusive niya sa partly diri sa assign na to diri sa grades 5, 6 and 7. Kay kuan man siya na igoman siya sa grades 6 to 10. Therefore, if that metal includes reaming, then niagi na siya og either cylindrical grinding, surface grinding, then you can select this the grades diri sa 6 to 10. 7 to 13 if naay grinding boring, then nag-include siya og turning. Then 8 to 13 if it includes boring, and sa range from grades 10 to 13 if nag-include nga milling, planing, shaping and drilling. Okay, so kuano, there might be problems nga ang kuan kung giyon sa pag generate ng hole. So for example, if the hole sa pin and hole ng assembly, if kuan siya gi drill siya, then you may use the grades 10 to 13 and determining the tolerances. So the same with the kuan katong sa different fits, kay naasad na siya kay every grade is na siya corresponding tolerance sa kada range sa nominal size. Okay, no? So from 0.04.12 up to 15.75 to 19.69. Okay, so these are the kuan mga tawag na itong mga properties nga properties that will determine sa surface finish sa usa ka material. Kining roughness, which refers to the relatively finely spaced irregularities of the surface. The waviness, which is the irregularities or departures from the nominal surface of greater spacing than the roughness. So the waviness is basically this is a mga siya og distance from a kano nominal surface. So since when there is a rough nga surface, so naan siya ay kano naan siya ay depth og tawag na to og higher sa gikan sa base, gikan sa pinaka base sa usa ka surface, then paitan dito kung asa ang nominal surface. Then the lay is the direction of the predominant surface pattern. So this in this illustration, so makita na to kung unsa ang gi-refer nga roughness, waviness og kuano katong lay. Okay, so nata gitawag og roughness height, because roughness is the relatively fine space irregularities. So we can say that this is a rough surface, and naa na tay kuan gitawag na to og kuano the ang roughness height. Yung roughness height is kuan ni siya the simply measured relative sa kuan relative sa katong kuan niya katong next nga base niya. So in succession, kung makita nga na siya deeper nga base sa yung roughness, then you can measure the roughness height. The waviness height is this is relative, or ang gamit nga reference point ini is katong gitawag nga nominal surface, or ang pinaka base sa whole nga katong kuan sa whole nga surface. Kung ansa ang unsa tong kung sa tong sample sa imong gi measurean. So muna ang difference sa roughness og ang waviness. Okay, so the lay direction is typically for ano, typically in how the surface finish was applied. So for example, the drilling, asa man ang direction sa drilling, is it going to this direction or that? So that could determine the or no, that determines delay direction. So kani siyang mga kuan, kani mga figures, kani mga figures is or the property nga roughness is quantified by kano, nan siya quantified by using these following equations, or roughness is quantified in two ways. First is by the average arithmetical deviation from the mean line. Okay, first off, the mean line is kuan, simply natay naay na siya pangitaon nga kuan. For example, sa total nga kuan, no, sa total sa imo sample na, no, is you locate the method of determining the mean line is ilocate tong usa nga point, which is the midpoint between the highest point in the deepest base sa imo sample of surface. So that's the definition of mean line. So gikan diha is the surf roughness denoted by R is represented by this equation. So nasa ikaduha nga method of quantifying the roughness by the so-called RMS or the root mean square. So root mean square is average is represented by this equation. So either of the two nga quantification of roughness is naa na sila gi-assign nga mga values di kuan. So depende sa unsang surface finish ang gi-apply. So but typically, and especially in sa katong reference textbook, is ang ginamit ani is ang RMS. Okay, so for isa kuan, for this specific nga range of RMS nga ingani ang kuan, ingani ang surface finish for this type of surface finish application. So if it is honing, nan siya ingani ang range nga roughness niya, and thus gamito na to tong values sa RMS in locating the tolerance. So in this figure, sa figure 3.9 is kuan, naay surface finish which is kuan, which is quantified by RMS. Then diri sa kuan, no, diri sa y-axis is that mo na siya ang sa tolerances in inches. So kani siya is mo na siya ang figure nga na generate out of experiments, no, from different nga mga different nga materials and different nga surface finish. So if if you know the surface finish niya in RMS, then and if you can use this, you can use this figure in locating the tolerance. Kaning sa ibabaw is different machine finishes. So katong machine finish sa man to, katong boring, honing, turning, ano siya? And this is gi-indicate dire ang mga machine finishes. So kani siya is naan siya gi-specify pag ganing nga mga kuano, nga mga materials, aluminum, cast iron, ani, and muna siya ang range of the kuan, range sa yung mga machine finish in RMS. Okay, so for example, sa kaning range of RMS from this to kuan, 250 to 16, this is only applicable sa aluminum nga mga materials. Okay, so that is all for the topic, no, and this is part 2 about the tolerances and surface finish, and I will give you your LT3. I will upload it in the VisuEE.